Okay, so let's start the last section of this presentation that will talk about estimation. So we have seen a lot of filters, nonlinear filters, particle filters. They will allow us to restore the state variables conditionally to a particular value of structural parameters. And we have seen that, it is in this slide, we can derive a definition for the sample likelihood. So that depends on the value of the structural parameter, okay? So we have seen that this is contribution to the likelihood here, is simply the sum of unnormalized weights. So in the general form, this is the sum on this is expression. And we have seen that it can simplify if we suppose that the proposal is simply the transition distribution. So we have a simplification here. And in case of resampling, systematic resampling of the particles, we have that the weights, the pass weights are equal to 1/1 n, sorry. So it is this quantity. So this is the quantity that we generally encounter in the literature. So the advantage to have an expression for the sample likelihood is that we can make an inference on a structural parameter set, whether using a frequentist approach, so we directly maximize this quantity, or in a Bayesian setup, if we combine the likelihood with priors for parameters. So we know that in the case of DSG model, it can also help to identify for identification purpose of some loosely identified parameters. Okay, so now let's discuss about a default of this approach. So the limit of the likelihood calculation is that we use resampling when we use particle filter. So the resampling step, in fact, is a way to update, corresponds to the updating step in the Bayesian filtering method. So we do that in order to avoid the degeneracy of the distribution of states. But the problem is that it complicates the inference by maximum likelihood because it renders the likelihood criterion non-smooth. So the point is that even if you set the seed of random draws across the simulations, the likelihood estimator will depend on the resample particles and on the unknown parameters. So when you change, even with a small change, the parameter value, it will cause a small change in the importance weights of the particles, and that will generate a different set of resample particles. So this introduces some kind of discontinuity in the likelihood criterion. So to have a graphical illustration, this is for the toy model, the Mocek. So that's the result when we have our estimation here, okay, for each parameters of the model. And we have the Mocek, namely this is a transversal cut of the likelihood or the posterior distribution for each parameter, keeping all the other constant. So what we see here is a Mocek implemented on with an estimation method that does not use the resampling process. So there's no particle or no resampling process. When you introduce the resampling step, you can see that the transversal cut now is quite fuzzy. So there is a lot of small variations, and these variations render the a maximization approach through gradient based method very difficult. So we can see that if we take a large intervals to compute the mode check, we can see that the transversal cut has a shape with a maximum, okay? But if we zoom too much, we can see that we can find clearly a maximum in this direction, okay? So this complicates a lot gradient-based approach, the traditional approach to maximize the likelihood or posterior distribution if we are in a Bayesian set. So how can we deal with this problem? So first, if you use particle, we can try not to resampling the particles and then implement maximum likelihood. But with the question, the issue of degeneracy, it is unlikely to be able to calculate the likelihood for the sample without resampling. So this approach is not very likely to implement. Second possibility is to use resampling and implement maximum likelihood, but with not a gradient-based method. So when you use a gradient-based method with order equal to 2 in dynar, you will have a warning message that asks you to confirm your decision. So the best way to implement things is probably to do resampling to avoid degeneracy and use a no gradient-based method to maximize likelihood. So Daniell simplex, simulated annealing, or CMAES. Third possibility, if you are in a Bayesian framework, to implement MCMC. And in fact, by simulation, you rebuild the posterior distribution of parameters. So this is the first solution, and we will examine it at first. The second possibility is to implement what is called an online approach. So the basic idea is that we consider the parameters as extra state variables. So we will derive an approach that is called online and that is implemented in Dyna. Another approach is to do smooth resampling, but in a DSG model context, it is unlikely to implement because smooth resampling works when you have only one state variable, one unobserved variable. So for after that, we don't have, for the moment, efficient answers on how to deal with multivariate state variables. So this is not it's not very useful. And at last, sequential Monte Carlo methods, and with the two approaches that are implemented but not completely available in Dynar, namely the dynamic striated Metropolis Hastings sampler and the ERPS and Shorfide SMC sampler. Okay, so I will focus on ERPS and Shorfide because it is the most it has been tested, and we only need now to provide the user an interface to use it. Okay, so let's begin with the Metropolis, with the MCMC approach. Okay, so the MCMC. So the very basic idea is to build point by point a discrete approximation of the distribution of the structural parameter conditionally to the information available in the sample. So this is called the posterior distribution of parameter theta. So when we use the Bayesian theorem, we see that this is distribution is equivalent proportional to the likelihood of the sample combined with priors on parameters. So there is a divided by a constant to obtain an equality, but it is not important because it does not depend on theta. But here, so we are in a Bayesian framework, and to have an inference about this posterior distribution, we need this quantity that is provided by a filter, and we have to suppose priors for the structural parameters. So when we are in a linear context, the sample likelihood here is provided by the Kalman filter. The good news is that when you use nonlinear models, you can replace, you can obtain the sample likelihood by using a particle filter. So the point is that the method will not change. The only thing that changes is the way you compute, you evaluate the sample likelihood. So in a nonlinear setup, the particle filtering will perfectly do the job. Perfectly, but will do the job. Okay. So if we do a particle random walk metropolis algorithm, so particle MCMC, or namely also you can call it particle metropolis Hastings, we in fact accept or reject a candidate for the structural parameter vectors, okay, starting from the previous one that we have accepted, perturbated with a shock that is drawn in this quantity, in this distribution, okay? And we have here a candidate that will be accepted or not, depending on the acceptance ratio criterion. And that will give you the next one, and so on. So the basic idea is to always accept a candidate that has a higher likelihood or criterion likelihood value, and accept only sometimes candidate with lower likelihood value in order to explore the whole distribution of parameters, but not to be stuck in the tails of the distribution. Okay, so we keep on exploring the mass of probability, the main mass of probability. We keep exploring also the tails of the distribution, but we only have the idea is that we explore sometimes the tails, but we keep most of time in the center of the distribution. Okay, so point by point, we can rebuild the posterior distribution of the parameter, since this quantity is provided by the filters that you choose, and here the priors that you have chosen for your parameters, and that this is easily evaluated. So with Dyna, how to implement? If you choose order equal to 2 to obtain a nonlinear resolution of the model, you can choose any filter algorithm you want. You can define a proposal approximation, distribution approximation, depending on the filter you choose. A number of particles, if there is particle, the resampling method, the resampling systematic or not. And here, you define MH replique to a value different to zero. And here, you define the name of the file containing the starting point for the algorithm. So the very good idea is that whether you use linear or non-linear resolution, particle MCMC, MCMC can also apply good conditions to the method, to the question. So here it is not complete, but we have made the same evaluation with the risky calibration, okay? So using a nonlinear method with order equal to 2, with the basics particle filter with systematic resampling, here is the evaluation that we obtain, sorry, when the likelihood is computed with 10,000 of particles, and we use MH replique equal to 5,000 with 10 blocks. Okay, so the inference is quite good for the structural parameter. Okay, and as usual, if you are used to implementing MCMC with Kalman, we obtain the distribution, the posterior distribution for each parameter. Okay. Second possibility to make an inference on parameters, the online approach that has been derived by Liu and West. So the idea is to obtain an inference about the posterior distribution of parameters, exactly as previously, but in a different manner. Here, we are supposing that the parameters of the model are extra state variables. So the idea here is to introduce extra state equations for these parameters. So we need to suppose something that will approximate a transition distribution for the parameters. Of course, here we are supposing that they can vary across time. So the idea is that we have a filter that is rebuilding step by step, time by time, the sample information. And to obtain an inference about this is particular state. So the idea is that it introduces the idea that the parameters are time varying, and it is not in the line of the model. So this method adds noises to the parameter estimate, and we have to reduce it to be coherent with the model. So the idea is to suppose as a scheme, as an equation, state equation for this parameter, a kernel shrinkage method. So the good idea, the pros of the method is that we only have one pass to do over the sample to obtain our inference on the structural parameters, and that it also works if order equal to one. Sorry. The cons of the method is that we need two resampling steps because, in fact, it is based on an auxiliary particle filter. And in this case, the second resampling step is important. It makes a difference. The other negative side of the method is that it does not have a strong theoretical foundation. So it provides some results, some interesting results, but theoretically, there's no strong theoretical foundation for the fact that it works, not quite good, quite well. So in one slide, to explain how it works, suppose it's a loop, as always, okay? So suppose that we know the past state variable at time t minus one. So we have a particle swarm that approximates them and see that we have the usual s t minus one, but now we have also theta t minus one. So we have here the set of structural parameters. And we have the weight as usual, and we have n particles. So the idea here is to compute the mean average of the particle swarm of the parameters for t minus one. And here we have our proposal for the parameters. Namely, we take a shrinkage method. So we make a weighted average depending on the parameter I will explain, I will discuss later, okay, about a mean average between the past particle and the mean of the distribution. So that gives us a vector, a value for candidate value for parameters. We compute a variance. And here, as it is based on the auxiliary particle filter, okay, we make a forecast on the structure, the state particle I, okay, at time t. So we take the previous one, we take the candidate for the parameters, and here we take the most likely value for the structural shocks, and we simulate one step ahead the state equation of the model. So we obtain unnormalized weights indexed on past, since as in the auxiliary particle filter, we will make a selection on the parents. That depends on the previous weight, and here the coherency between observable at time t, the candidate on state at time t, and the candidate on parameter at time. So it's called t minus one, okay? And that gives us weights in that will allow us to resample. So we resample and we obtain this index exactly as previously as a result, okay, for the resampling process. With that, we draw in a normal in Gaussian distribution using what we have the moment we have computed here before. That will give us a proposal for the parameters. We put it here and for the same index coming from the resampling process, we make a transition in order to compute a proposal for the state variables, okay? And by the way, at time t, and by the way, we deduce using the definition of weight for the auxiliary particle filter, the unnormalized weight, okay, for particle L. We normalize, and eventually we make another resampling step, okay, to obtain the equivalent at time t of this particle swarm. And we go so on up to the end of the sample. So exactly the same approach than the auxiliary particle filter, except that we have extra steps, okay, to have a transition on the so-called latent state variable that correspond to the structural parameters. So here, the choice of A is based on the delta parameters that is generally chosen between 0.9 and 0.99, okay? So the literature gives this range. So you have to explore to define the solution that to obtain a solution. And how to obtain that in Dynar and what are the outputs. So you can choose order equal to one or two, since it will work whether with a Kalman filter, whether a nonlinear filter, so an auxiliary particle filter. You have to define the number of particles. You have to define if you want an extra resampling step at the end of after the, so on the children, so each time or not. And to choose the good this approach, you have to choose mode compute equal to 11. So here another application for the risky calibration. So the online particle filter here with the results obtained for the last evaluation of the state variables, so the for the parameters, okay, so for the last observation of the sample. So that gives us something that is close to the posterior distribution of the parameters of the model. So here we choose 10,000 particles, delta equal to 0.9. And here we choose without systematic resampling and here with systematic resampling. Okay, so it gives reasonably good evaluation for the parameters, for the deep parameters. That is not excellent, but the size of the sample is small because we have only 150 observations. Another output from DINAR is the evaluation for each time, for each date of the sample, okay, of each parameters. Okay, so here in the center of the graph, we have the mean and the median of the distribution, of the particle distribution for this parameter. And here we have 95% confidence band. Okay, so you can see that there is a variation. And in fact, we are only interested by the last one, okay, since it contains the information, all the sample information. So what we are interested in for our inference on the posterior distribution of parameter is the distribution for the last observation of the sample. Okay. So here for the every deep parameter of the model. And so at last, we can draw the posterior distribution with a kernel, with kernel evaluation of the distribution, okay, for each parameter, for each deep parameter of the model. Okay, exactly as in a MCMC approach. Okay, so I won't talk about the dynamic striated Metropolis Hastings sampler by Zah, Wagoner, and another one. But I will talk about quickly UPS and Shore 5D SMC sampler because it is quite tested now, and we only need to put to add an interface for the user. Okay, so the basic idea here is also to have an inference for the posterior estimation, the distribution for the deep parameters theta. So the idea of this approach is to use this quantity here. So this is nearly the posterior distribution, but here we have an exponent on the likelihood of the model. So here we have not exactly the posterior distribution. It would be the posterior distribution if this parameter phi n was equal to 1. So the basic idea here is to imagine a sequence of phi n, okay, that starts from 0 to 1. And if it is zero, in fact, this distribution is simply the priors of the parameters. And if it is equal to one, this expression is simply the posterior distribution of parameters. So this expression is called the tempered likelihood. And the idea of the sampler is simply to imagine to build the sequence of parameter phi starting from 0 to 1 in order to have to make evolve the distribution of the parameters, starting from the priors and finishing on the posterior distribution of parameters. So the point is that in their application, ERPs and SureFide use linear model. So in general here, the likelihood is provided by the Kalman filter. Here in our in Dynar, you have to choose the order of resolution, and if order equal to 2, you have to choose the filter that will give you the likelihood of the model. So it will work for every filter that you can choose. So in one word, because that's not the point the most important of the presentation, but the fact is to start with draws for the parameters with weight. So we start with something that is equal, with weight that are equal, and they are drawn in the prior distribution. And you have a sequence here, okay, that gives you the parameter phi n. So you have to choose the number of iteration you want to make and the value of alpha, of lambda, sorry. And doing that, you make evolve the distribution you have toward the posterior distribution of the parameters. So when you have these particle things, you have to compute the tempered, you have to update the temper with the new parameter phi and with the previous weight of the particle. So that gives you an unnormalized parameters, weight, sorry. You can do eventually an optional resampling step in order to focus in the area that are the most interesting to evaluate this is distribution. So the you choose the particle of parameters that are the most coherent with observable at time t, the most coherent with the sample likelihood, sorry. Okay, and as you have impoverished the composition of your swarm, you can make one metropolisasting steps in order to introduce some small differences, okay, to reintroduce heterogeneity in the particle swarm. So the application for the risky calibration as usual, okay? So you can see here that we can choose any filter that we want. We can choose the Kalman with order one or a nonlinear Kalman filter or a standard, okay? And here, in case we use particle filter, here we have chosen a Monte Carlo Kalman filter. We have compute the likelihood with 10,000 of particles, and the parameter this approximation, the number of particles that approximate the posterior distribution is 100,000 particles. Okay, so of course here I set only 10,000 because it's quite it could probably be slower in order to obtain some result relatively fast. Okay. So at the end, of course, we obtain the same representation of the posterior, the same estimation of posterior distribution for each parameter. This one for the Kalman filter, this one for the nonlinear Kalman filter of the previous table, and this one for the particle filter, the standard particle filter. Okay, so to conclude this session, we have a small table that summarizes every possibilities on filters for the proposal choice, the proposal approximation, the state distribution approximation in case we want to do resampling or not. So the The idea is that we have presented the main, the most interesting filters of the literature. We have also introduced a lot of filters that are, in my opinion, a little less interesting. And we have shown how to make an efficient inference on the posterior distribution of the parameters of the models. So I hope you have enjoyed the presentation. And we can meet if you are interested or if you have questions in the Zoom question answer session that are scheduled on Wednesday, if you want. So thank you very much for your attention and see you.